I got my springs, and they fit just right into the pockets. Should be good. So I'm just trying to figure out now a mounting. Hope you can see that. You put the washer on, but it doesn't fit very well, does it? I hope you can see this. The first thing you have to do is, number one, is one side of the spring is a larger diameter than the other side of the spring. The larger diameter is going to go on the seat. The smaller diameter is going to go bolted in. So the first thing you have to do is take that and make it, how would you say, level. In other words, knock this point off, just as I've done right here. Just take your grinder. Doing work like this, chances are pretty good you've got a Dremel. Smooth it off. Don't leave any sharp edges. And then you should be able to insert a washer. Maybe. Let me get this in here. The washer in and drop the bolt straight through. There we go. Another bolt on the other side. And that'll give you a flat surface for the washer to sit on. A nut on top of that. And then you're going to run into another problem. You want that centered. Well, in order to get that centered in there, you'll have to be able to put a socket down in there. Well, I'm using 9/16. I refuse to go to half inch. It's just too small. So I have to knock off the edge in here of this spring, which I've already done with that one. So the 9/16 will fit down in there, and the socket itself will center the all of this exactly where you need it. So we'll just start grinding this on the inside edge right here. This is where it needs to be filed down. I tried opening it up, bending it open and everything. All I'm going to do is just destroy the spring trying to do that. It's really good spring steel, and you just wreck it.
Thank you.
Yeah. Now we've got two pieces that are, well, I don't know if you can see that or not, but they're not standing straight, are they? We're going to take them in, put them in the vise, and straighten them up. All you have to do is clamp the bolt in the vise and kink the spring a little bit to make it fit where you want it, make it stand where you want it. Then it'll stay straight. Well, these, I'm going to bolt down through there and through there. And these, this is not cast aluminum yet, are going to fit on top of those. So it's obvious then that the seat itself is going to tell us where to put the holes. That should be about it. This, remember, is sitting on an angle like that. We're going to make little fillers out of some tube to go in here. They won't be very big, but they will be there. And these will fit down through. And then the top is just going to sit right in those things. They're not going to mess about at all. I'm just going to sit right in there. So I think that's about what we're looking for. I'm going to have to get it up on the bench so I can see it. Mark where those holes are going to go. That should be right. And that's how it works. Now you notice at the front there, I've left everything with lots of room for adjustment back and forth. That can be that front piece. If the person doesn't like that, they can cut that off. It's just aluminum. Comes off easy with a cutting wheel. It looks fairly straight, I think. And if a person wants the seat lower, you can shorten these and round them up to fit inside a little bit. They don't have to stick that far through. I can trim another quarter of an inch off of those both sides. That'll give you a if this were, let me just set you aside here for a sec. If this were on the angle that it is, it would be sitting up. That, leaving the seat pretty straight to start with. These are going to compress a little bit, not too much, but that's the angle, about the angle of the frame, maybe a little steeper than that. And try your very best to get it lined up right, because boy, if you don't get it lined up right, it'll look like crap. This has to come back a ways. The holes are in the right place, but the whole seat has to come this way a little bit in order to get everything lined up properly over here. So I'll go ahead and mark the holes, because that's the most important job right now. That's what I need, is where those holes go. So I can get the nuts on the back side and make the little, just steel tubing, 1/8 wall. I cut it on flat on one side and whatever angle this is on the other side. And then they sit in there, right over top of those nuts that you have here. This little sleeve sits in there. And then you just bolt it all together tight, nuts from the bottom. Later. And that's what it looks like with the holes drilled. There's the little spacers cut in. Yeah, it looks reasonable. I guess the sun's pretty bright.